This is a three-part laser maze that's basically a training course to become the world's greatest secret agent.
I'm doing a fancy move.
Yeah. Oh, no.
I tried to do a cool move, and it didn't pay off.
Easy.
Oh, no.
Welcome back to Space Camp CrunchLabs. I'm Mark Rober, and this is week three of your least boring summer ever in space. Now, you should be working on your at-home super challenges from last week. We've already got a few already, and I gotta be honest, they're pretty dang good.
Can you get me a Reese's?
Thank you.
Now, as a reminder, camp is two parts. There's the mega experiments that we do here, along with the at-home super challenges that you guys do. And then there's part two, which is the super fun CrunchLabs build boxes. And they get delivered right to your porch every week while we build them together, and you have a ton of fun while learning the kind of skills that allow you to do all the cool stuff we do here at camp. Now, we saw some of your super challenges earlier, but don't forget, that's not just for bragging rights. If you're one of the top four, you not only get this signed Camp CrunchLabs official space mission patch, but you get a chance to win this bad boy, a platinum ticket. That means you're coming out here for week eight to completely obliterate this backyard in the name of science.
Oh no!
Now, of course, this year, it's not just Camp CrunchLabs, it's Space Camp CrunchLabs. And that means each week, I pack up my backyard to visit a new planet in the solar system and share some juicy nuggets of celestial information. The best part about doing camp in space, no mosquitoes. So the question is, where are we this week?
If you check out over my shoulder, you'll see a planet. It's red, rocky, and home to one of my personal old robot friends.
That's right, we are orbiting my second favorite planet, Mars. Or more specifically, we're technically on one of Mars's moons named Phobos. Now, as you guys know, I worked at NASA for a decade. In fact, my name is Mark Rober, which is just two letters off from Mars Rover. On top of that, I spent 7 of those 10 years at NASA working on the Mars Curiosity rover. So I've designed and integrated and tested hardware that's rolling around that little red dot in the sky 90 million miles away. And even more cooler than that, humans are going to Mars. We will step foot on that planet, and the person who will do it is alive today, and it could even be you watching right now, which is just so awesome, and I'm so glad you're here. All right, well, let's get right to our special guest this week by snapping him in.
Whoa, Mark?
My buddy Max from Toys and Colors, welcome.
Hey.
To Mars.
Mars?
Technically, this is Phobos, a moon of Mars. Mars is up there. What is your favorite planet, by the way?
Pluto.
Pluto?
Yeah.
Well, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but it's no longer a planet. All right, well, let's head over to our picnic table of endless wonders.
Whoa.
The first thing we need is some campers. According to my space log, we had some stowaways on the rocket ship. Campers?
Hey, Mom. Hey, Mom.
Were you guys hiding in the secret compartment?
Yeah.
I guess you're here now, so get the heck down here.
Hi.
Welcome to Mars, up top.
Yeah.
Okay, can you guys guess what we're doing here? Okay, I was hoping you'd say that. Dim the lights. Oh.
There we go.
Now I do this.
Whoa.
I can see it.
Lasers. Oh, I might have done too much. Whoa. What's the number one rule when working with lasers? Where do you not shine them?
In your eyes.
In your eyes.
That's right. We are trained professionals here at CrunchLabs. Be super, super careful with lasers. All right. What if I told you guys I know that the moon is exactly 228,621 miles from Earth right now? Would you be impressed?
Yes. Yeah.
Thank you. But it shouldn't be that impressive because I just looked it up on Wikipedia. But the more impressive part is how we know that. And could you take a guess how we know that? Literally to the nearest centimeter? Here's a hint.
Lasers.
Yes. So when the Apollo astronauts placed a mirror on the moon, it was a special kind of mirror. Who wants to come over and help me with this? Okay, come over here. You raise your hand first. See the laser? It's bouncing off this mirror.
Uh-huh.
I want you to try and get it in that red box. Line it up. Okay.
that?
That was actually pretty good. That was very impressive. So this represents the moon and that represents Earth. Now you were able to line it up and do that, but the moon is really, really, really far away. 228,621 miles to be specific. So it's really hard that far away to line it up. So you wanna know a trick? I would just take this right here. I'm not even gonna look and see if I can hit it in that square. Ready? You think I can get it to bounce in that red square? Did I do it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, now I'm just gonna do it again, not even looking. Did I do it?
Yes.
There.
You wanna know the trick?
What?
This is called a retroreflector. We have three mirrors that come at a point. What do you see when you look in there, no matter which way I turn it?
My face.
Exactly, your eyes. So as long as you hit that mirror, it'll come right back. And the important part then is you time how long it takes. Because we know how fast the speed of light is, so if it takes 2 seconds to come back, we can measure exactly how far away the moon is at any point by using lasers shining at the moon.
Wow.
Super cool.
Have you guys seen these before?
A bike, yeah. A car.
Yeah. Yeah, and do you know the purpose of those?
To shine the light back.
Yeah, look.
Whoa.
There's little tiny retroreflectors, mirrors like this, on here. So no matter which angle it's at, the headlights from the car, they'll always light up so the driver sees you. All right, well, these are all well and good, but they're a little bit small. I feel like we could go bigger. And if we're really gonna go bigger, we can't do it here. Now brace yourself. All right. Technically, we're still on Phobos, just a different part of the moon. And although we do have a cool floor, the one thing we're missing is a referee.
Oh, hey guys.
Science Blog Blue Builder.
Hi. What are you guys doing in the middle of the laser maze?
What?
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 What laser maze?
This laser maze.
Whoa!
Yeah. Yeah.
So cool. Bob, these aren't dangerous, right?
What do you think? These are not dangerous.
I feel like I should have asked you that first.
All right, guys, I know it looks like a lot of fun. But this is actually a competition.
I'm scared about this.
In round one, each team must make their way from the start square to the far side of the course as quickly as they can, but they have to avoid touching the lasers. For every laser beam they touch, there's a penalty. Once they reach the far side, they must both press the yellow reset buttons, reactivating any tripped lasers. They then need to navigate back to the start. The lowest score wins.
We're gonna need some teams.
Kids versus adults!
What?
Kids versus adults!
What? You don't wanna be on Mark Rover's team?
No!
Oh, all right, fine. Max, let's go.
Let's go. All right, here we go. Uncle's up first. Ready? In 3, 2, 1, go.
All right, let's go, Max.
Don't hit the beams, don't hit the beams.
Here we go.
All right.
Oh, this is too easy. I don't know. Oh, Max!
Was that me?
It must have been you.
Wait, I don't see it near me.
Oh, Max! Oh, no! Oh, I'm hearing a lot of beeping.
That is you.
It may have been me. Ow! Okay, Max, I'm doing a fancy move.
Keep going, keep going. Hand on the pedestal.
Okay, okay, okay.
Let's come back.
All right, the beams are back.
Okay, we can go over.
No laughing.
Oh.
Another beam broken.
Oh, this is a problem.
That's a penalty. Oh, another penalty. Oh, no. Good, hand over here. Okay. Keep your hand on the pedestal.
Yeah.
Okay, there's one. There's the other.
Hey, right. 597.
597.7. That's your score to beat. All right, kids are up.
Okay.
On your mark. Get set. Go. Don't break any beams. Oh, don't break
good.
Any beams.
Oh, wow. They're very good. Oh, the hair. Watch your hair.
All right. Watch out. Oh, there's another penalty.
Was that me?
Oh, whoa, wow. Nice whoa. Moves.
Whoa. Your hair. Hold your hair. Wait, why am I giving tips?
Yeah, why are you giving tips? Come on, Max.
Wow. All right, hands on the pedestal. There's one hand. There's the other hand. All right, it's reset. Come on back.
Oh, why is their score so much lower than ours?
Doing great.
What? Oh, no.
Take your time.
Take your time.
Hurry up. We got one. All right, and there it is. End of the game.
You guys are way better at laser mazes than high five, I'll say that much.
You guys ready for game two?
Yes!
Yeah. Here are the rules.
In round two, contestants have 40 seconds to try to break as many laser beams as possible. When both contestants hit the yellow reset light at the same time, the lasers reset and the game continues until time runs out. The highest score wins.
All right, kids are up first. On your mark, get set, go, break the beams. There we go. All right,
hit your hand over there. Same time.
There, go. Break them all. Okay, there you go. Now run back. There goes, go back. You got 1 second left. Time's up. 234.
All right.
Find your mark. Get set. Bust the beams.
There they go.
Ooh, very fast. There they go. Touch, good coordination. Break them all.
Oh, no, they're winning.
Yeah! 10 seconds left.
Oh, they're doing really good.
This is so fun. Yeah.
Adults rule!
We did it!
What's up?
This means we have a tiebreaker.
Okay, so this will establish once and for all who's better, adults or kids. There's a lot of pressure riding on your guys' shoulders.
All right, so here's how this game works.
In round three, the game starts easy with the fewest number of lasers. Contestants must avoid the lasers to try to get to the reset button. When they do, more lasers are added. Hitting a laser results in a time penalty. Contestants have 90 seconds and the highest score wins.
Uncles are up first. Good luck. On your mark, get set, go.
Too easy.
Watch the beams.
Got it. Okay. Oh, this is gonna be a high stretch. Okay.
More beams.
Whoa. It was by my face.
Come on back.
Whoa.
Come on, Simon.
Okay.
Oh, you
broke
a beam.
Oh no, I didn't see one.
All right, now go back.
Oh no.
Get this one.
It's just the easy level, guys. They're not doing great.
Oh no.
You have 25 seconds left. All right, more beams.
Oh, wow, right between my legs.
Watch it.
Oh, yeah. Wah! Oh, no.
Penalty.
I tried to do a cool move, and it didn't pay off.
14 seconds left. Oh, yeah. Penalty. All right, game over. 1,697. Oh, no. I don't know if you guys would make good secret agents. All right, kids are up. This is the deciding round. On your mark. Get set. Go. All right, there they go. Stepping. Wow, they are fast.
Wow, that was too fast.
All right, you got more beams.
Oh,
there you go.
Oh, got me there.
Watch them.
Oh.
Step over. Good job.
Go.
Come on back.
That was not a secret agent move.
24 seconds left.
Oh, wow, these kids are good. Wow!
Oh, you're getting tired.
Yeah, I think they're tired out.
Not me. Yes!
Oh, wow!
Wow.
That was a disaster. That was,
all right, and end of game.
Oh!
Yes!
And let's look at the score.
Yes!
What the heck?
All right, guys, the kids kind of dominated that. You guys are the winners of the last game, which means that you guys are the ultimate winners of the CrunchLabs laser games.
Wow. You guys are ready to go into government spy work.
Okay, yay!
Man, I am 0-2 at Space Camp CrunchLabs competitions. This is not a good start for me this summer, Bob. And you know what else isn't good? The fact that you guys are up way past your bedtime. Get the heck out of your campers, back on the rocket ship, go. Don't break the beams. Fine, break the beams. Max, it's been an absolute pleasure. Bob, I would appreciate better officiating result next time.
I accept cash.
Good to know. Well, that was eventful. And who knew Mars was hiding such an incredible laser maze on its biggest moon? Back to base camp we go. All right, well, that was a lot of fun. So while I am packing up my backyard and heading to the next planet, you might have some guesses which one it might be. You should be working on your at-home super challenge. Now remember, this needs to be uploaded to campcrunchlabs.com by Tuesday, 11:59 p.m., so I could check them all out, and then we can watch a bunch of your submissions next week. And while you're there, your parents can get all the details on getting your CrunchLabs bill box every week for the summer instead of every month. And so between doing the bill boxes and the at-home super challenges, I'm giving you a Mark Rober guarantee this will be your least boring summer ever, and by the time you go back to school, you'll have, like, tripled your chances of going to Mars. Just don't ask me to put that guarantee in writing. All right, well, the temperature is about to drop 250 degrees here at sunset, but we'll see you next time on a brand new planet right here
at Space Camp CrunchLabs.
All right, time to pack things up.
Start by blowing out this fire.
Worked a lot better last year.